Mexico. You feel me? I love Mexico. Mexico, you know what I mean? Our neighbors, I love Mexico. Mexico got some of the best players that I learned to admire. You know what I mean? I've seen them play live. Of course, my two favorite Mexican players that I've seen play live is Blanco. I love Blanco, short little fat guy, but a beast with the ball at his feet. You know, and I love Borghetti for all the goals that he has scored with his head. You know what I mean? The stamp, definitely legends in the game of Mexican soccer and world football as well, if you was paying attention. But Mexico released their retro kit. Mexico retro kit is beautiful. You know, the colors of the flag, green, you know, red, white, is definitely stand out. You know what I mean? So definitely Mexico. Then Mexico World Cup kit's always been beautiful. That green is just that money green, man. That green is shiny. But Mexico going to the World Cup, many people say that that's a possibility of them being in a group of death with Germany, Sweden, and South Korea. You know, Mexico is no stranger to the rounds of 16. There, you know what I mean, they falls basically come after the round of 16, not getting at the round of 16, you know what I mean? But the group stages, Mexico always find a way to get out of it. You know, for the last 6 World Cup, them and Brazil is the only sides that I've gotten out of the group stages 6 consecutive times. So you know Mexico, you know what I mean, is a nation full of ballers. But this Mexican teams will need to come with a set lineup. They will need to come with a set lineup and not keep on rotating. And they definitely need to actually, you know what I mean, make Jonathan Gonzalez, you know, definitely, you know what I mean, molding him with the team, make him actually focus, because he could play a pivotal part in the central of the park for Mexico. Letting Chucky Lozano doing what he do best on the wings and, you know, and attacking and giving key passes. You know, Jonathan Gonzalez will definitely be a great addition. That, you know, I thought that was a great stealth under the nose of U.S. soccer that was being sleeping. But the Mexican coach need to stop with that rotation shit and stop playing players out of position. You know, and go back to Mexican football and playing your hardest. When the team is better than you, we just know you're going to come out playing Mexican football. And whatever happens, happens. And most likely Mexico do get the result. Mexico, I definitely could see them beating Sweden. But Sweden is a very defensive team. That's why I stated that Jonathan Gonzalez needs to be at the helm of the crown to basically pull the strings together for Mexico. To give, you know what I mean, Chicharito. To give Carlos Vela all those passes that they are needed. You know what I mean? Godardo, you know, will definitely need to bring his, you know, leadership. And we all see Rafael Marquez, after being accused of being a drug kingpin. Understand me talking about, you know, we would like to go and play at his last World Cup, which I think would be an addition to Mexico, as Rafael Marquez is the definition of a hardworking Mexican. I could give a fuck about what he has done in his personal life. But when he's on the pitch with a little ponytail and, you know, the halfway socks, he gets the job done. But Mexico, no shortage, you know what I mean, of fans. I'm pretty sure I have a Mexican friend that works, you know, at a restaurant. You know, he's actually going to Russia to watch the games. I think he's going to watch a Mexico game. I'm not too sure. I think I made fun of him because he wasn't going to go watch a Mexico game. But the fact that he's going to the World Cup, I told him I wanted him to document it and all that, you know. But what do you guys think about Mexico? What do you think Mexico needs to fix to get past beyond the round of 16? What do you think would be the chance for Mexico to make it to the quarterfinals or semifinals? And do you think Mexico have what it takes to beat the big, bad Germans? I definitely see that I could think they could beat Sweden. That's where Jonathan Gonzalez is going to be pivotal for them and playing the attacking, you know what I mean, central attacking mid. Then they got South Korea, which could be a tough side. They might make it at the group stages, but when they come to the World Cup, they put on a show. They go all and out. And then the most important match, which I think Mexico is going to play their best football at, even if they win, lose, or draw, it's against Germany. Mexico is definitely going to come out stating that they don't have nothing to lose but to go at the Germans, you know. Football hasn't yet been kicked. It's not June 14th yet, so it's yet to determine where Mexico is going to end. We all could just make predictions. But I definitely think this is the year that Mexico get past the round of 16, you know what I'm saying? Because Mexico is definitely a great side. And now we see new young bloods replacing the old, you know what I mean? It's like a switching of the guards. But, you know, and I definitely wouldn't mind seeing Ochoa or that young goalkeeper, I forgot for what team he played for. I don't know if he's not Club America. Cruz, probably he's a young goalkeeper, you know, very talented. I wouldn't mind seeing him debut at the World Cup as well. But definitely let me know your thoughts in the comment section down below. Hit the like or dislike button. I love you all. I wouldn't say it if I didn't mean it. The World Cup is coming.